Permanent maxillary second molar is the seventh tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDS system is 17 and 27, in universal system 2 and 15, and in Zsigmondy-Palmer system it is 7 with appropriate quadrant brackets. It develops from 4 developmental lobes, mesiobuccal, distobuccal, mesiolingual and distolingual, which give rise to 4 cusps respectively. It has 3 roots, mesiobuccal root, distobuccal root and lingual root. Its function is grinding. In chronology, the tooth erupts at the age of 12 to 13 years, due to which it is sometimes also called as the 12-year molar. Coming to its dimensions, the cervico-occlusal length of the crown is 7 mm. The length of both buccal roots is 11 mm and lingual root is 12 mm. The mesiodistal diameter of the crown is 9 mm and at cervix it is 7 mm. The buccolingual diameter of the crown is 11 mm and at cervix it is 10 mm. The curvature of cervical line on mesial side is 1 mm and on distal side it is flat. The morphology of a tooth is studied under 5 aspects. Let us start with the buccal aspect. The outline form of the crown is trapezoidal with the shorter side towards the cervix and longer side towards the cusps. Both the buccal cusps, mesiobuccal cusp and distobuccal cusp are seen, in which the mesiobuccal cusp is larger. Part of distolingual cusp is also visible. The mesial contact area is at the junction of occlusal third and middle third, whereas the distal contact area is at the middle third. Both outlines, the mesial outline and distal outline, are convex. However, the cervical line is irregular. A faint cervical ridge is seen running mesiodistally in the cervical third. A buccal developmental groove is seen running cervically between the two buccal cusps. From this aspect, all three roots are visible. The root trunk is seen bifurcating into mesiobuccal root and distobuccal root, whereas the lingual root is seen partially in the background. All roots have a slight distal tilt. Next, the lingual aspect. All features of the outline form of the crown from the buccal aspect are seen in the lingual aspect as well. The features which are different are, both the lingual cusps, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp, are seen, in which the mesiolingual cusp is larger and sharper and distolingual cusp is smaller and rounded. Partial distobuccal cusp is also seen. A lingual developmental groove is seen running cervically between both the lingual cusps. All three roots are visible from this aspect, with lingual root in the front and both buccal roots seen partially on the sides. All roots have a slight distal tilt. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form of the crown is trapezoidal in shape, with longer side towards the cervix and shorter side towards the cusps. Both mesial cusps, mesiolingual cusp and mesiobuccal cusp, are visible. The mesial marginal ridge is seen running horizontally between the two cusps. Both buccal outline and lingual outline are convex. The height of contour of lingual outline is in the middle third and that of buccal outline is in the cervical third because of the cervical ridge. Only two roots are visible from the mesial aspect, the lingual root and the mesiobuccal root. Distal aspect. All the features of the outline form of the crown from the mesial aspect are seen from the distal aspect as well. Apart from that, both distal cusps, distobuccal cusp and distolingual cusp, can be seen in front and part of the mesiolingual cusp is also visible. The distal marginal ridge is seen running horizontally but at a lower level than the mesial marginal ridge, because of which more of occlusal surface is visible. Unlike the mesial aspect, from the distal aspect, all three roots are visible. Finally, the occlusal aspect. From the occlusal aspect, two types of maxillary second molars are seen, one with rhomboidal outline form and one with heart-shaped outline form. This variation in the form is due to the differences in the development of distolingual cusp. It is more developed in rhomboidal form and less in heart-shaped form. The rhomboidal form is more common and will be discussed here in detail. The acute angles of the rhomboid are at the mesiobuccal line angle and distolingual line angle, whereas the obtuse angles are at the distobuccal line angle and mesiolingual line angle. All four cusps are seen. Mesiolingual cusp, which is the largest, mesiobuccal cusp, second largest, then the distobuccal cusp and distolingual cusp, which is the smallest cusp. Among these, mesiolingual cusp, mesiobuccal cusp and distobuccal cusp are the primary cusps which form the maxillary molar primary cusp triangle. And the distolingual cusp is the secondary cusp. Ridges. All four cusps have two cuspal ridges each, mesial cuspal ridge and distal cuspal ridge. All four cusps have one triangular ridge running from the cusp tip towards the center. Two marginal ridges, mesial marginal ridge on the mesial border and distal marginal ridge on the distal border. Apart from these, oblique ridge is a ridge formed by the combination of distal ridge of the mesiolingual cusp and triangular ridge of the distobuccal cusp. And transverse ridge is formed by the combination of two triangular ridges of mesiolingual cusp and mesiobuccal cusp. Next, fossa. There are two major fossa, central fossa and distal fossa, and two minor fossa, mesial triangular fossa and distal triangular fossa. One pit called the central pit, which is present at the center of the central fossa. Grooves. Buccal developmental groove, which starts from the central pit, runs buccally onto the buccal surface. Central developmental groove, which starts from the central pit and ends in the mesial triangular fossa. Distal oblique developmental groove runs from the distal triangular fossa, runs through the distal fossa and continues as lingual developmental groove onto the lingual surface. Other than these, numerous supplementary grooves are seen. In clinical considerations, fixed orthodontic treatment is usually done after the age of 13 years, that is, after the eruption of second molars.